Lego road plates, a controversial subject. Many are still in tears over the apparent discontinuation of the classic Lego road base plates and its new, potentially unsightly, replacement, road plates. Controversy aside, I was interested in seeing how well Lego road plates worked with brick filming. For years, I've just been using regular base plates covered with other plates or flat tiles for roads in brick films. They weren't optimal by any means, but they worked. Sometimes, I even built walls and put them sideways and used those as roads. All good solutions, but what about road plates? Is their convenience worth the look? Is the look really that bad? Let's dive in.
Convenience.
If you've seen my recent brick films, Captain D-Rom in Time Time Turmoil and Lego Woman Turns Into Car, you may have noticed that road plates were featured prominently in a few scenes. This was my testing ground. Using a handful of Lego sets, I collected enough road plates to create a pretty decent stretch of concrete to satisfy my needs in these films. This long road used a bit of forced perspective to sell the look, and yet it was still decently long. I wouldn't have been able to make this shot without road plates, or at least a lot of base plates and other plates. They're definitely convenient and easy to set up.
2. The look.
But what about the look? Compared to my old style roads, I like them. Yeah, there are some weird lines on them where the tiles fit inside the main plate, but I'm gonna overlook that. After all, everything in Lego has seams. Walls, minifigs, you name it, all have seams. So this is no different. As for reflectivity, I have a love-hate relationship with the way they are reflective. On one hand, I really like how the reflection looks. Lego should be shiny, I get that. But on the other hand, I had to mask this wire and the reflection out of this shot, and it was somewhat difficult, especially with the shadows involved. So, all in all, I'll accept the look.
3. Cost and availability.
Until Lego discontinues the set that is just the road plates alone, you can get these fairly cheaply. You can get a stretch of 4 road plates plus 1 sidewalk for $20, which is a pretty good price for the convenience it offers me in my films. To put that into perspective, this entire set is 4 road plates plus 1 sidewalk long. My camera only showed about 2 at a time in most of these shots, so that's honestly plenty for most situations. Of course, they're increasingly being featured in other LEGO City sets too, so chances are, if you're a LEGO City fan, you'll probably pick up a few of these along the way.
Final thoughts.
So, all in all, I enjoyed these, and would recommend them. Are they better than a base plate, a sideways wall, or a classic road base plate? I can't answer that, because it's up to what you have. But personally, if you have some expendable funds, it wouldn't hurt to pick up one or two of these for whenever you might need it. So, thanks for watching my review. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you want to see more brick films, reviews, and tutorials, as well as other stop motion content in the future, please be sure to subscribe. And comment below and tell me, would you consider road plates? Or if you already have them, do you like or dislike them? I'd love to hear what you have to say.